Welcome to the Daily Reminder Network. Heart Softeners by Sheikh Mu'izz Bukhari.
All praise and thanks be to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is our creator, sustainer, nourisher, protector, and curer. We ask Allah the Almighty to shower His choicest of blessings and salutations upon our beloved Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family members, his companions, and all those who tread upon his path with utmost sincerity until the day of Qiyamah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless this gathering. May He the Almighty bless each and every one of us. May He bless the viewers of the Daily Reminder Network and all of us. May He open the doors of goodness for us and may He grant us success in this world as well as the hereafter. Ameen. Inshallah ta'ala, the heart softener tonight will be on al-waswas. It will be on al-waswas, otherwise translated as obsessions, evil whispers. We will discuss inshallah ta'ala. Al-waswas, we have something known as al-waswas al-qahri and al-waswas al-shaytani. We have something known as al-waswas al-qahri and al-waswas al-shaytani. You see, there is two different things. Psychologists have identified al-waswas as an obsession and they call it OCD, obsessive compulsive disorder. This is on one side. And on the other hand, we have al-waswas al-shaytani, which affects an individual in terms of his ibadah, in terms of things related to aqidah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all from al-waswas. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states in the Noble Quran, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ مَلِكِ النَّاسِ إِلَهِ النَّاسِ مِنْ شَرِّ الْوَسْوَاسِ الْخَنَّاسِ الناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس. From the whisperer when he whispers, min sharri al-waswas al-khannas alladhi yuwaswisu fi suduri an-nas, when he whispers in the chests or in the hearts of mankind. Allahu Akbar. Shaytan, the devil, he comes about and whispers in our minds. Now, coming back to those two elements, obsessive compulsive disorder and al-waswas al-shaytani, you see, let us first define these two and give a few examples in regard to them. An obsessive compulsive disorder is an anxiety related problem, a psychological problem, where the individuals who are affected tend to go through this disorder where they involve themselves in things of a repeated nature. Say, for example, they would keep on washing their hands. People who are affected with OCD, obsessive compulsive disorder, they would keep washing their hands so many times. At times when they meet someone, they want to wash their hands afterwards because they have this fear or the apprehension that there's bacteria. They always have this fear. They would wash their hands so much that at times their skin dries out. Allahu Akbar. And or they would involve themselves in various rituals, like perhaps closing and opening a door for a particular number of times. Say, when he wants to enter home, he will open his door thrice. Open, close, open, close, open, close, and only then he is satisfied. When he enters also, he opens, close, three times, and only then he is assured that the door is locked. And even then, when they go back to sleep perhaps, or go back into the room, they have this thought in their mind that they have to go back and double check the door. So then they come back again three times. Open, close, open, close, open, close. This is an obsessive compulsive disorder. They have this problem. And likewise, Allahu Akbar, we have brothers and sisters who are affected in regard to ibadah too. There are people, Allah save us all, but then when they, I'm just doing this to illustrate or give you all examples, not to make fun of them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all from al-waswas. Save us all from all these types of obsessions which are closely related to an individual's heart. When they go to make ablution, they are not happy. They wash their face once, twice, thrice, and they always feel that sense of as if it's not complete. They want to keep washing so many times. They wash their hands so many times. Say when he comes to the masjid and he wants to tie takbir, the imam has tied the takbir already, but he is still stuck in takbir. Allahu Akbar, and then he's still not sure. Then again, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. He ties takbir repeatedly so many times. And at times he feels as if, you know, I did not pronounce the ba properly. So Allahu Ak, Allahu Ak, Allahu Ak, he keeps repeating. The ba did not come. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. They keep on repeating. And perhaps they've gone on to the surah and then it comes in their mind, did I recite Surah Al-Fatiha? Did I recite Surah Al-Fatiha? Then he comes back and recites Surah Al-Fatiha. So it becomes very stressing on an individual, and that individual is so preoccupied in all of these problems, he loses the spirituality of prayer. He cannot make it with the imam because he is struggling and battling from within. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all from such obsessions. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cleanse and purify our hearts. So scholars, rahimahumullah, they state that these obsessions, the root cause is from shaitan. The root cause is from shaitan. Shaitan, Al-Khannas, he is the one who comes and puts these evil whispers in our minds. Allahu Akbar. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said, and the narration goes along the lines of these words, that when the hadith is in Muslim, when a person, for example, if one of you, when you are in salah, if you feel something funny in your stomach, if you feel something funny in your stomach, like perhaps a gurgling feeling in your stomach, do not leave your salah. In other words, if you feel as if you have broken your wudu, if you feel as if you have nullified your ablution, do not leave your salah until and unless you hear a sound, until and unless you hear a sound or you smell a bad odor. These are the two conditions. From this we understand the scholars, rahimahumullah, they state that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam identified OCD, obsessive compulsive disorder, because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's treatment there is not to say a'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajim, or to seek refuge from shaitan. No, but rather to reject those thoughts, those obsessive thoughts that are intruding your mind. Reject them. Reject them. Build upon yaqeen. Do not have shak. Do not have doubt. Build upon certainty. Do not have doubt that your salah is broken. Do not have doubt that your salah is broken. And in terms of ibadah, we cannot decide upon doubt. Say for example, an individual is in salah, he thinks, have I forgotten Surah Al-Fatiha? Have I forgotten Surah Al-Fatiha? Now he cannot come to a conclusion based on that doubt. Rather, he has to come to a certainty. Yes, I forgot Surah Al-Fatiha. Then his salah is not valid. Or else he has to come upon a certainty. Yes, I did read Surah Al-Fatiha. Then he has to proceed. And even if he hadn't read Surah Al-Fatiha, because of that thought, that certain thought in his mind, his prayer is valid. Allahu Akbar. These are the cures and treatments given, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, to shun away OCD, to shun away obsessive compulsive disorder, so that our hearts don't give in to obsessive compulsive disorder. Say you feel like washing your hands repeatedly, you shun away that thought. You feel like opening and closing a door 3-4 times, you shun it away. Just once is enough. You shun the thoughts away. The more you give in to those thoughts, the more you become trapped in that cobweb of OCD, obsessive compulsive disorder. But on the other hand, if it is al-waswas al-shaytani, if it is from shaytan, then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has given us a few cures. Number one is that we should try and recite Surah Al-Baqarah as much as possible. If an individual, if a brother or a sister is afflicted with al-waswas al-shaytani and even al-waswas al-qahri, obsessive compulsive disorder, these cures are from the authentic hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It will cure that individual. Number one, you should stick to Surah Al-Baqarah. Recite Surah Al-Baqarah as much as possible, because in one narration Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said, and the hadith goes along the lines of these words, the house in which Surah Al-Baqarah is recited in, the devils flee away from that house. Allahu Akbar. So if that's the case with the house, then what about an individual? If an individual recites Surah Al-Baqarah, naturally the devils and the shayateen are going to flee away from him. So let us try to recite Surah Al-Baqarah for the ones who have been afflicted with al-waswas. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cure them, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all from al-waswas. Number two is that we should recite Ayatul Kursi, the greatest verse, the verse which has been
There are so many virtues in regard to Ayatul Kursi. The verse that has been inscribed on the footstool of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ayatul Kursi, has many powers. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said that the individual who recites Ayatul Kursi in the morning, the hadith goes along the lines of these words, an angel, a guardian is appointed over him from the malaika, from the angels, to protect him until evening. And in the evening, if he recites Ayatul Kursi, he is protected until the next day morning. Allahu Akbar. So we should try to recite Ayatul Kursi. That is number two. Number three, we should try and recite the Mu'awwidhat. The three Qul surahs. Number one, Qul Huwallahu, Suratul Ikhlas, Qul Huwallahu Ahad, Suratul Falaq, and Suratul Nas. These surahs came down as a cure for all of these evil things, such as black magic, such as jealousy, such as protection from the devils. So we should try and recite the three Qul surahs. And finally, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we should turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in dua and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cure us if we have been afflicted with al-waswas. And after doing all of this, if the waswas still persists, then that individual has to be pleased with the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he has to take it as a test, and he has to remember that it is not the anger of Allah upon him. Don't ever think a person being afflicted with a particular sickness, a particular problem, a particular anxiety, that doesn't necessarily mean it's the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon him. It could be a trial, it could be a calamity, it could be a test to polish him to the better, to give him more rewards, to purify him, to cleanse him of his sins, to raise him in darajat, in ranks, to give him a higher status and rank in Jannah. Allahu Akbar. So he should be happy with the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and go through that test bearing patience. For indeed, he will be rewarded. But there is this slight difference between the two, and it is upon us to be able to differentiate between the two, nevertheless seeking refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the accursed devil and taking the necessary precautionary measures to stay away. Number one, being positive, and also following the adhkar that I just mentioned. Be positive and shun away those thoughts, those intrusive thoughts that come into your mind that makes you do certain things. Just shun away those thoughts and build upon certainty and positivity. Insha'Allah ta'ala, the problem will be solved. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of our sins. And may He cure us from all of these diseases, these obsessions. And may He help us to do more and more good deeds, resulting in us attaining the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May He the Almighty help us to complete this beautiful month of Ramadan, attaining His pleasure and freeing ourselves from Jahannam. And may He the Almighty unite all of us, just as how He united us here tonight with our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa akhir da'waya an alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Jazakumullahu khair.
Donate now. Go to www.thedailyreminder.org/donate. And stay updated by joining our network's social links.